What's up, YouTube? Let's talk about this Captain Marvel.
Look into my eye.
Yeah.
What's that on that beat, hope?
I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. Pull up to the scene with my ceiling missing. Pull up to the scene with my ceiling missing. Pull up to the scene with my ceiling missing. Pull up to the scene with my ceiling missing. Middle finger up to my competition. I'm different, yeah, I'm different.
What's up, YouTube? It's Artisan MC, and I'm here to talk to you about another movie coming out soon, Captain Marvel. We're about 1 week away from this movie. I'm looking forward to seeing it. Captain Marvel is one of those characters that I like. May not be in the forefront, but it's one of those characters that I like. It's a real strong character. To answer one rumor right off the bat, she is not strong enough to take Thanos ever in history of comicdom. That ain't happening. But moving on past that, I'm sure you can get the history of from a lot of other YouTubers out there. Comics Explained does a good job. Rob, love your work, but for me, it's not on that. This is more so my review, my opinion of what I see coming and what I see right now. And the biggest thing right now is Brie Larson popping her mouth off and saying some ridiculous stuff about this character in the movie. And if her goal was to tank this movie before it came out, I can say she succeeded. I did not see the comments that she made live, obviously, but I checked out some other videos and heard the things that she said. And I don't know, maybe there's a point in there somewhere she was trying to make, but it stands as a testament to completely missing the mark. If she wanted to be really smart, she would have did what Gal Gadot did and not pitch the movie that she's in as a feminist movie. I don't know if Brie Larson has her finger anywhere near the pulse of pop culture, but they're not really receptive to that. As much as all this feminism and stuff like that gets crammed down our throats, it's starting to back up and turn into some steaming heaps of vomit because people don't want to see that. That's not what they're going to the movie for. And if she's actually read the comic, Captain Marvel, Ms. Marvel, whatever you want to call her, is not a feminist character. She's not. She likes dudes. So I really don't see where the comments would help anything, by and large, except to ruin the movie that she could stand to make millions of dollars off of as a franchise. But to get into it, the character Captain Marvel has been around for a while. Yes, a number of years ago, she actually took on the Captain Marvel moniker. But as a character, I like Carol Danvers. If most people don't know anything about Carol Danvers, the easiest way to understand who she is to go to the X-Men and look at Rogue. Everything you like about the character of Rogue from the animated series or in the comics, the flight, the strength, and all of that, comes from Carol Danvers. She got those powers from Carol Danvers because Carol Danvers was the one she touched and absorbed permanently that power set, which made Rogue really a force on the X-Men. Okay. Outside of that, Carol Danvers, Ms. Marvel, Warbird, the number of names that she's gone by have all been attempts to keep that character relevant and keep that character interesting. For me, her most interesting time came in her recent solo book, which they have like three or four of right now because of the movie and whatnot. That makes sense. But the last one about two or three years ago that I really enjoyed. I really enjoyed that one and the one that led into her leading Alpha Flight on the space station. It was good. It was kind of what DS9, you know, esque. You know, she's on a space station, she's running the team, it's fine. It was her first role stepping up as being captain and running the team, I'm fine with that. But all of the stuff that's happened since then has been kind of shit. I mean, even the new book that's out right now, I'm in a shop, it's not really selling. So, one of the most striking things that most people don't know is that her boyfriend was War Machine James Rhodes. So not only was she in a male-dominated field as a fighter pilot, she had a boyfriend who was also in the military, but it was a black man that she was really fond of. So all of that feminist stuff kind of doesn't fit in with this character. Now, if that was the movie that Brie Larson thought she was making and Marvel Disney signed off on that, then that's something else to be seen. So for me, the character sits in a place where she is massively powerful, good personality. She has been wrong on many occasions, especially when they prompted her to be Captain Marvel and being the leader of some stuff. She made some serious mistakes. That Civil War II, that's all her. She fucked that up, you know. Granted, her boyfriend, War Machine James Rhodes, just got fucking killed by Thanos. Yeah, that's sending you over the edge a little bit. But everything she did after that was her own choices, and they were mistakes. And they were huge ones that kind of Captain Hydra played upon and just set the whole superhero community in an uproar. You know, so there's a lot of stuff there. As far as the character being liked, I like her most with the Ultimates, the omniversal team of the Ultimates, being her, Blue Marvel, Black Panther, Spectrum, one other person I'm forgetting, but that team was like the OP team, and they dealt with some serious stuff, and she fit in on that team. Her power set was perfect for that team. Her most interesting stuff for me comes in when she is interacting with other superheroes and she's interacting with her friends. Like, the stuff they've done with her and Spider-Woman is fun. Even Spider-Woman as this single mother with a baby by somebody you don't even know who he is. The stuff that they get into back and forth is pretty funny and kind of reminiscent, in a sense, for me, of Superman and Batman going at each other. For me, I will look forward to this Captain Marvel movie because I want to see this character portrayed on screen. Do I believe this character will take Thanos? No. Do I think the movie will flop? Possibly, based on what Brie Larson had to say. And for me, I like Brie Larson as an actress, but that was monumentally a dumb move. So next week, I will probably give a 1 week moratorium on spoiling anything for anybody, but after that, weapons free, like BGS says. So until the next time, I'll see you and have a good one.
My spidey senses is tingling. Got my radars.